Welcome back to Matter of Fact. As protests dominate the headlines, a pandemic still looms in the background. Washington State had the first confirmed case of COVID-19 in the country and put its largest city, Seattle, in a race to solve another crisis, finding shelter for more than 10,000 homeless people before the virus spread through that vulnerable population. Could Seattle's response to the outbreak change how the country addresses homelessness beyond this moment? Lola Najera had just arrived in Seattle when COVID-19 first hit. She considered herself lucky when she landed a spot on a friend's couch.
I was in a shelter downtown, and there were so many people in that shelter. It was so close that I didn't feel safe, and I had to go out. And so I packed my bags and I went out.
Seattle and King County estimate they have between 10 and 12,000 homeless people like Najera. Those in shelters were suddenly in the path of a deadly pandemic.
I've always been worried about the homeless population and the individuals that are living so close together. We know that that's almost a perfect storm.
A storm that had been brewing for years. King County was already dealing with another crisis, a lack of affordable housing.
It is a little bit of a paradox because, you know, as people have had more opportunity and in general wealth has increased, folks have been squeezed out of housing. There's a lack of housing. The housing exists becomes more and more and more expensive.
This new crisis has forced them to scramble to find ways to get the homeless to safety. They started searching for housing to isolate the sick and installed hygiene stations so the homeless could keep clean.
We will want to identify anybody that may have been a close contact, whether that is other residents, shelter clients, or staff or volunteers.
They sent teams out to test for COVID-19 inside homeless shelters. 204 staff and residents tested positive. King County moved about 500 people out of shelters and into hotels, and some into isolation until they recover.
It's really scary because you feel like you can't breathe and you don't know if it's your last day or not.
Overnight, new housing went up, or at least tiny housing.
Usually a village like this would take us like maybe three, four months. But because of COVID-19, we have staff and volunteers and contractors that are helping set this up in 3 weeks.
Then in late May, as the number of infections was slowing, the police broke up some homeless encampments, which forced the inhabitants into indoor shelters where COVID-19 spreads more easily.
My concern is that they're spending a lot of money from the, you know, the COVID response money from like the feds or from FEMA, and they're putting people in hotels or they're putting people into like public spaces like Seattle Center. And then I think the thought is that the moment, like the absolute moment the crisis is over, all the homeless people are going to be back on the street.
For now, thanks to the COVID-19 response, Lola Najera is doing better. She has a tiny home to call her own.
To even say those words, this is my home, my heart swells up. I have a home. I'm safe.